Hey, Faye. Hey, everybody. So, what you guys trade today? How you guys do on a slow day like this? I'm gonna start a couple minutes, guys. Every day, regardless of slow or not, is always a learning experience, guys. Because not every day is going to be, you know, big, crazy volume type of day.
Gather some thoughts together, and then we'll start in a minute and think what I want to talk about today.
All right, guys. Alex, are there any action items for MIC before I start? Tomorrow is Tosh's webinar, guys. Every Wednesday, he has a new member orientation at 2 p.m. market time. So let me tell you the schedule of our events. For the free events, which is these webinars, Alex does it on Monday. It's the YouTube Live. I do it on Tuesday, the Instagram Live. Tosh does it on YouTube and Zoom on the webinar on Wednesday. So this is a lot of free stuff we give out. You get even more when you join. So let me go through the webinar list, which is, I think, is not mentioned often, but these are the key things which make people successful. It's not just going in and watching us trade or watching videos, but then you need to have an interactive session, mentoring. So this is the type of mentoring we're talking about. No one does this except us, by the way, because we do it weekly. We do it on Tuesday, which is Joe's large cap. So there's a large cap and options webinar for 2 hours a night. On Thursday, Austin does another webinar, a strategies webinar on Thursday. And on Saturday, we have Saturday Q&A. So pretty much this is like education in terms of a university. So you're attending classes. So think of MSC as the whole goal is to become a trading university. That's our goal. We're not here just to be a chat room. We're not here just to pump you stocks. We want you to really learn. We really feel like, you know, with the education costs rising of college, this is actually the most affordable. It's like a trade school. It's like going to nursing school, welding school, mechanic shop. You know, so don't think of this as like, okay, it's a hobby you learn. This is why I don't understand. People go, oh, it's too expensive, you know. $200 a month? Imagine if community college or if a university costs you $200 a month. That's insanely cheap. And to be graduating in maybe a year or two versus 4 years and being heavily in debt, this is like another option that people don't understand about. And you do it right, you know, this could be life-changing. And so we want to change the aspect of the education universe. It's not just a bunch of gurus teaching and pumping and dumping. You know, this is real live university type of education. That's what we're aiming for. That's what we're trying to set up. And people don't understand because they have a very sour taste of other communities where the community is just a pump and dump community. But, you know, we are trying to change it. And it's a very difficult thing to do because it's like there's so many people out there giving us a bad name. Us as in the education. And so with that in mind, I want to just talk about like today. Today was a really slow day, guys. And even a slow day like today, Alex and I woke up at 3:30 a.m. my time. Alex was there before. So we're in there educating the room. Just because it's slow doesn't mean we stop working. It's, you know, who knows if it's going to be slow until the market opens. But the point is, you have to research. You have to be there. I see these other guys showing up so late and start pumping and dumping. That's because they're not really teaching you. And so you really think about it, guys. The level of your success is actually proportional to how much work and effort you put in. I thought I was waking up early at 4 a.m. That was not early enough. I was not getting the locates I want. I was not doing the research, getting the proper research I want. And so, you know, I've been getting up at 3:30. It's very difficult, especially in California, but you know, this is the price of being, if you want to become successful. Today was a super slow day, guys. Super slow day. And then the only thing that I really made money was let's see, what stock was that? See, it was so slow, I don't remember. APVO, I think. Yep, off of the 8 line. I posted that, and then I really didn't know how much I was gonna make. I follow the process. You know, I don't hide my P&L, guys, but I don't look at that until the trade's over because I'm too busy focusing on the charts, on the action, right? And then I look and I go, oh shit, I'm up like 2,900 bucks. And then I just didn't feel satisfied. The weird thing, because the last week, up until now, it's been like $10,000 days, you know, big numbers, right? 7,000, 6,000, 10,000, whatever it may be, right? Today was so slow. And so sometimes we forget how much $2,900 is. If you think about it, that was my first job out of school was $36,000 a year, an engineer, software engineer. This is a long time ago, albeit, but it was $36,000, $3,000 a month. And we just blasted that in like half an hour. And I'm not happy with that. You know, and so it's kind of those, you have to get yourself, bring yourself to like reality, okay? This is why casinos give you chips. So, because you don't really know what a $100 chip looks like. It looks like a $20 chip. But then if you see those in stacks of 20s, you're like, holy shit, that's a lot of money, guys. And that's the problem with just numbers on the screen. It's just numbers on the screen. But then when you think about it, if I gave you $3,000 to spend a day, it's very difficult unless you buy stupid things. If you just living expenses, it's a lot of money. But as a trader, sometimes like when you make three, you're pissing off making five. When you're making five, you're not making 10. You know, you take what the market gives you. And on a slow day like this, it's very, so I'll tell you why I said 2,900. So I made 2,900 and I was like, fuck, I'm almost at, I think it was 28 or 29, pretty close. I was trying to make $100 more just to reach 3,000 because I got bored. I was like, okay, I want to say I made 3,000, right? You know what I did? So I tried to make $100, but then I ended up losing $300. Just trying to make the $100 fucking dollars, forcing trades, guys. You know, I was so fucking bored. You know, I was like, because I mean, once again, the cushion game got into my head because I was so bored. I was like, I'm going to mess around. I'm going to make another $100. You know, I'm just sitting around waiting for Instagram Live to start. And I just lost like $300 just sitting around, just messing around. But then when I think about it, I was like, dude, I went to the store. I was cheap to buy a shirt that was not on sale. You know, I was like, I'm not going to pay $100 for this shit. But then I just pissed away three shirts. You know, it's just stupid because, so this is what I want to remind you, because on Twitter, you see guys making shitloads of money, 50,000, 100,000. But you know what, man? You can't compare yourself to them. They're trading million-dollar accounts. They're willing to take the big risk. And so if you compare your chapter 1 to their chapter 20, you're screwed. Even those guys are screwed. I mean, I'm pretty sure most of those guys, like, I mean, do they own fucking like five houses to be risking that shit? It's just kind of stupid, you know? To each their own, I tell you right now. But I'm a more realistic person. So what we teach at MIC, like look at Alex, man. You know, if you think about it, 3,000, 4,000 a day, if you do that on average, it's $1 million a year, guys. It's one fucking $1 million a year. That's a lot of fucking money. But people don't see the long run. They only see the quick hit money. And it's just kind of, in my opinion, this is the way that I became successful. This is the way that Alex became successful. I cannot talk about anybody else's strategy. For me, when I reduced it down to how much a day I have to average to get to my goal, those are achievable goals. Doesn't mean I'm going to make 3,000, 4,000 every day. Some days I could lose. Other days I'll make 10,000, make up for it. But the point is, if you take a look, it brings you out to reality. Because when you look at even $200, you're like, I only made $200 today. But let me take a look, okay? I am going to bring up this. Because on slow days, I want you guys to not do stupid shit. Trying to force, you know, because every day is different. And I give you an example of trying to make $100, messing around, I lost $300. You know, just stupid shit like that. There you go, guys. You know, $200 a day supplemental income is life-changing money. That's $50,000 a year. Who can make $200 a day? You guys all can make $200, man. All you guys have made $200 in a day. But the problem is you want to make $1,000, then you end up losing. So it becomes very inconsistent. The key to trading, guys, the key to trading is consistency. That's from my point of view. It's not these home run stocks, all that. Because I'm trading, I'm planning to trade for a long time. I'm not just here to trade for one time, gamble and all that stuff. And so it's really difficult to try to get that into beginner's head, because they don't want to make $200. It's sexy making $20,000. It's sexy pumping and dumping and going for these crazy home run stocks. But then at the end of the day, you know, it's like, how many people actually become super rich in that strategy? And then you look back, you're like, I wasted 6 months. Fucking, I lost money in 6 months. If I just made $200 a day, that's $25,000, guys. It's $25,000. So the reason I keep saying $200, because that's life-changing for most people, okay? It means that you can eat whatever you want. Stop thinking you need $1 million to change your life, okay? Have a job, supplemental income, trade an hour a day, make your $200. The reason why I keep saying 200 is because if you can make $200 consistently a day, you can make 500, you can make 1,000. It's leveling up, but first you have to make it $100 consistent, then $200. But you see, it's very easy to make $200 a day, in my opinion. The problem is most people don't want to stop at $200 a day. But they don't understand it. If they can make $200 a day, they can make $1,000 a day. It's the same process, guys, a repeatable process. And on slow day like this, you know, I'm looking at Alex, I'm like, you know, I'm kind of pissed off because it's just like there's nothing moving. And we're so used to making these big numbers that when things like this, we start to just dick around. And that's breaking your discipline. This is a job. This is not ego. This is not gambling. You go and you take what the process gives you. You know, I could have easily fucking lost $3,000 back. Again, squeezed on stupid shit, trying to make $100. It happened before, man. I was trying to make a couple $100, ended up losing like $10,000 before. Shit, stupid shit like that. You know, you end up giving up all your cushion. And so on slow days, you should be glad sometimes they're slow. We trade, if you are a trader, you trade supposedly for freedom. But for some reason, we're glued to this fucking screen. Get off the fucking screen, go outside and live life and be free. And this way you don't need to be a full-time trader, guys. I'm just sitting around, nothing to do. It's like fucking 8:30 over here. What am I going to do? So I can have another job. So my job is MIC. I'm helping members. I'm doing that thing. It's not like I'm a full-time trader. Being a full-time trader sucks. I'm telling you right now, man. It fucking sucks. You have no companionship. You have no coworkers. You are just by yourself. And it's like a longing to be part of a community. And so, you know, it drives you nuts. It takes a very special person, which is like a really deranged person, to be able to sit by themselves for 8 hours a day, 40 hours a week, not talking to a single human being. You become really weird. And so that's why it's kind of like you trade for freedom, but yet, you know, you're obsessed to the screen because, you know, nothing is ever satisfied. And so that's why I take vacations. So I hear these guys saying, no days off. Fucking work, oh work, bull fucking shit. You will burn the fuck out. You know, that's what happened to me, man. I worked nonstop 3 years, never took a day off. And it's like, yeah, I reached all my goals, but I was fucking miserable. I fucking gained like 30 pounds. My health was horrible, hardly slept, nervous wreck, pissed off all the time. Couldn't socialize with anybody. It's just kind of, you know, You know, there's a balance, okay? And I'm going to tell you the secret, guys. It's not how much you make. It's how much you make in the littlest time possible, in the shortest amount of time possible, with the least amount of stress. Because you know what? The difference between $200 and $300 is not much. The difference between making $4,000 and $10,000, you may think it's a lot, but I mean, your life is not going to change. You're still a million a year. Who gives a fuck if it's a million or 2 million? It's like, you know, but if you're going to have to risk your life and stress to do this.
Oh, shoot. Let me see what I got. I got blind orders out. Oops. Okay.
You know, say this thing. I'm still fucking drained. I'm so addicted, you know, because I'm so bored. I need to leave. And so sometimes, guys, because I hear a lot of people, they you know, what else am I going to do all day? And this is why I keep telling people, do not quit your job. Because being a full-time trader is not about trading all the time. Being a full-time trader means that you are there for the opportunity. You're able to sit there at the optimal times. But if you have a job that occupies, let's say, the open of the market, it's very difficult to trade, you know, and then go to work at those hours. So the way you could do it is this, guys. It's a little trick. Pick a job that allows you to have the window of opportunity so that you can trade. So before you start, before you think about quitting your job to be a day trader, what you need to do is find a job that allows you to trade during those hours. And that's what happened to me. I was very fortunate so that I was an engineer, so I could trade in the morning and I go to work. But without having a job, I would be so stressed out, paying the bills and all that stuff, you know? And look at me, I'm sitting here, I have no pressure. I made the money, the only pressure is myself, I'm bored. So the hardest part is the discipline, guys. And that's why you need a tab. You know, this is why I do what I do, IG Live. You know, you find a hobby, you find whatever, just to get you off of the screen. And I guarantee you guys, we always say less is more, but what is less? Less means just stop over trading. You trade at the optimal hours and you don't give back. It's the bleed of boredom that costs you money every day. Imagine I just threw away $300 because I was up like 3,000, right? Whatever the fuck. It's like whatever. But that's $300. Imagine you do that every day for 5 days. That's $1,500. 4 weeks, 6,000 a month. That's $72,000 fucking dollars a year. I just pissed away. Something like that. $75,000, dude. $300 a day is $75,000 a year. That's $60,000, something like that. You know, but it's a lot of money. $300 doesn't mean much when you think $300. But when you fucking do it every day, same concept of making money. If you're going to bleed the money, it adds up, man. And, you know, because that's my entertainment. My entertainment just fucking around, you know? But, you know, for a lot of people, that's a lot of money, even myself. So I want to quit now, you know? But for me, I'm just bored, entertained, you know, doing this. But so I'm just giving you guys an example of my bad habits, okay? So be aware of that. And, you know, today is really slow. The markets are really slow. You got to take what the market gives you, guys. I'm not going to talk too much right now. The whole thing about today is just telling you guys that, hey man, it's okay to be slow. Be realistic with your goals. Even if you made $200 today, guys, fuck man. You think about the guys on the mall working in the hot sun. They work all day to make $150. So don't think of yourself at $200 as bad. Don't compare it to yourself to anything. You know, focus on yourself. Don't look at other people's P&L. Because for me, sometimes I get pissed off. Like, why is this dumbass making so much money, right? You know, so you start to feel competitive. But to be honest, dude, don't compete with anybody except yourself. You want to compete with yourself, be better version of yourself the next day. That's, you know, and keep it realistic. I've been really realistic, and I knock on wood, I don't want to say anything, but, you know, like, guys in them, I say, no, when I lose, I tell them I lose. And it's been a long time, knock on wood, right? And then I look back, 3,000, 5,000, 6,000, 10,000, whatever, it adds up. It adds up, guys. When I look back at the end of the week, I'm like, oh shit. You know, it's like I had to wire out twice, you know? And so keep it realistic, guys. That's why Alex has a stack of hundreds, you know? And to keep it realistic, you have to wire out and see how much that money is. because the numbers on the screen, if you just look at the numbers on the screen, it's just meaningless. But when you think about what you can buy with it, so instead of thinking $300, okay, I could have thought, fuck, I could have bought three of the shirts that I didn't want to buy because I was cheap, it was on sale. You know, when you do that kind of stuff, you know, it puts everything into perspective and you'll be a happier person. Okay, numbers don't mean shit. But when you equate it to something, an example would be taking your parents out for dinner. $300 could have took out the whole family to a nice steak dinner. It means a lot now, right? $300, it means a fucking a lot. It doesn't just mean $300, it means a family dinner that you paid for. And when that happens, when you equate the numbers on the screen to real life events, your whole perspective changed. And that it changed me. You have to have a goal. You have the goal. Goal could be, I need to make enough money to take my family out. Simple as that. And by doing that, in my opinion, you will change your perspective on numbers on the screen to real human value. All right, guys. That's it. There's nothing much today. We'll see you online.